The Devils have really contained the Penguins in this building. Pittsburgh just 5-12-3 here. How come?
Matchups. Last change. The Devils get last change at home. They get the right matchups on the ice against Crosby. They get the right defensive pairing, so you should see Green and Larson against them a lot tonight.
Pittsburgh has won more games against the Devils at home, but here, this ice has favored New Jersey, guys.
And Dev, with his 43rd start this season, Corey Schneider already equals his career high. Lately, it's not quality. It's not quantity, it's quality that is the story. His .921 save percentage, sixth best in the National Hockey League among goaltenders with 30-plus games. At the opposite end, now in his 11th NHL season, Marc-Andre Fleury has not had a smooth ride. 15 goals allowed in his last four starts. Winless in that stretch. At the All-Star Game Sunday, he allowed 7-1 period. That's a day very few take seriously. And he seemed rather upset about it all. He was being ridden by the crowd there in Columbus.
And I think that's why goaltenders dread playing in an All-Star game, as we always see a more of a pond hockey game, and with the skill level, the forwards and defensemen, so many goals, 17-10. So it's not good for the confidence of a goaltender, but you have to brush it out of your mind and understand that all it is an exhibition and an All-Star game.
Ready to go at the Rock. Sidney Crosby on a line with Chris Kunitz and recently acquired David Perron. That's the top unit for the Pittsburgh Penguins that starts out against Zajac, Eliash, and Martin Havlat. Work to center, and Crosby chases it back in his own zone. Penguins' last trip here, they lost the game, but Crosby had one of the more impressive goals on a wicked backhander to get the scoring started. Taken here by Andy Green for the Devils, and worked ahead to Patrick Eliash. Travis Zajac with the intercept dumps in. Tonight's lineups are brought to you by Infiniti, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance. Simone Dupre across to Chris Letang, who picks up Nick Spaulding at center, and he fires into the Devil's zone. Loose puck gobbled up here. Scott Gomez banks it away, and it's played across by Rob Scuderi.
We've talked about Corey Schneider, Stephen, the way he's been playing as of late. And Devils, to a man, understand they're not going to get away with too many victories the way they played against the Toronto Maple Leafs. Yes, they had a break. They were rusty. But that was all Corey Schneider stealing that hockey game for him. Look for them to be much sharper tonight starting this game against the Pens.
And picked up by Adam Henrique. Works it across looking for Yager, and the ex-Penguin sees that broken up by the new addition to the Pens, Maxime Lapierre. This is just his second game since a trade days ago from St. Louis. Picked up here by John Merrill for the Devils and worked to center and steered in by Dinah Zubras. Bortuzzo got back. It's icing against the Devils.
Well, first-year head coach of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Mike Johnston, this is where he earns his keep, Steve. This is where the Penguins, we see every year, it seems, no matter who's coaching, they go through a lot of injuries, a depleted lineup, and they're able to weather the storm. It's easy to coach when things are going well and players are at their best, but right now, Penguins struggling a little bit. They have some health issues. This is where Mike Johnston really finds out what his team's all about.
As Crosby getting a shot away on Schneider, and Corey Schneider with his first big stop of the night on the Penguins captain. The big omission from Mike Johnston's lineup tonight is, of course, Evgeny Malkin, missing his fourth straight with a lower body injury, as Steve Bernier punches this into the Pittsburgh end. Robert Bortuzzo is hit. Bernier lets him know that he's there as this puck comes out to center. Green working it across. No Malkin in the lineup. It's an easier matchup for the Devils or anybody who'd be playing the Penguins when you can't split up the big two.
Malkin, to me, is maybe the most dynamic player in the National Hockey League. He is a guy that can go end-to-end and win a hockey game single-handedly. So, yes, the Devils do get a break with Malkin out, but you can't let your guard down because we know other guys will be picking up, and Sidney Crosby wants to get back to his form he's accustomed to.
Earlier this week, Pittsburgh won a game without either one in the lineup against Winnipeg. 5-3. Tuomo Ruutu collecting the loose puck here for the Devils and works this across. Pass for Ruutu, taken away by the Penguins. Andrew Ebbett skates in and shoots, and that's fought off by Schneider.
Another good save by Corey Schneider, cutting the angle down, and he hasn't missed a beat early on here. Penguins with more of the pressure on the Devils. Couple of chances. Corey Schneider makes the save on Ebbett.
worked across to the stick of Mark Fraser to center ice. Travis Zajac trying to pick up the loose puck, but instead it comes to Patrick Hornquist. The first-year Penguin, longtime Nashville Predator, puts it on goal, and Corey Schneider's gotten the first three. Here's Havlat chipping it out to center. Shoveled ahead by Zajac, but broken up by Brandon Sutter. Loose puck taken here by Zajac. Tries the power move, and he shot it off the side of the net. Martin Havlat nurses it back. Marek Zidlitsky on the puck and sends it in. Patrick Elias in the corner trying to shake loose of Bortuzzo, and the puck taken away. This is the fourth of five meetings between the division rivals. Penguins won twice at the CONSOL Energy Center this year. The Devils, 3-1 winners here back on December 29th. Shoveled ahead by Henrik. He collides with his own teammate in Zajac, and Schneider picks that out of midair.
Corey Schneider, real good early on here. You're going to see Devils turn the puck over there in their own end. Sidney Crosby picks it up, goes hard to the net, and with the little chip shot deflection as well. Looks like Perron got a piece of that, but Schneider there, very square to the puck, makes a save in there. Andrew Ebbett dashing down the left side. Not much to shoot at as Corey Schneider again takes away a lot of the net.
Off the draw, quick shot, trickles to Schneider again, and he's forced to make the stop early. Scuderi following up and plays this behind goal with help from LaPierre. Loose puck gobbled up by Mike Camilleri. Getting a shot away, and the save made in front. Steve Downey with the scoring chance out of nowhere, but Schneider is sharp in the early going. For the first time this season, the Devils are finding some traction at home. They're 4-1-1 in their last six at Prudential Center. Half of their victories at home this season are in that stretch. Lou Lamoriello saying today he's not a fan of the balanced schedule. If he had his way, Devils would go back to playing Pittsburgh, New York, and Philadelphia eight times a year. A lot less travel that way, right?
Well, less travel, rivalries. But then fans don't get to see some of their star players that they want to see. And it's a little give and take on both. And I think Lou just likes the fact that we could play in the Eastern Conference a little more often.
Saves on gasoline and jet fuel, I'd imagine. Here's Letang working this ahead. Puck taken by Zach Sill. Works it across. Taken here by Crosby. The return pass, and that shot broken up. Letang tries to put it towards goal. Schneider with one save and then another on the follow-up. Centering try by the Penguins and taken away by Green. The Devils able to snuff that out, but a flurry by Pittsburgh.
It's been all Pittsburgh Penguins in the first 5 minutes here. Bombarding the Devils. They got to get crisper. There's Adam Larsson. One of the guys we talked about in the opening, how well him and Andy Green have played together since joining each other, and they're going to need him tonight. You see Sidney Crosby looks like he's on his game early on, and coming off a 4-0 shutout in Washington, you knew the Penguins would come out ready to play. They've shown that, and if not for Corey Schneider, this may be a lead for the Penguins.
Somewhat humbling a couple of nights ago, Alexander Ovechkin scoring twice against his nemesis Crosby. 4-0 the score. They didn't test Braden Holtby a lot. He was the game's number one star, but it was somewhat misleading of what unfolded that night. As it's taken here by Gomez, worked back to Zidlitsky. That shot is blocked away in front. Controlled by the Penguins and worked ahead here to Sill, who dumps in.
The early going here, a lot of these chances from the Penguins, they just seem a little step quicker than the New Jersey Devils right now. And the Devils have turned the puck over in their end, which is uncharacteristic. Two or three times in succession, the Penguins have had good chances on Corey Schneider.
Camilleri on the forecheck here, trying to get on the loose puck. Worked away by Pittsburgh, and Sutter gets it out to center. Hornquist shovels it into the Devils' end. On the loose puck is John Merrill, who punches it ahead. To the stick of Bernier. Steve Bernier on the move. Rookie defenseman Scott Harrington is back to deal with him, the 21-year-old, playing for the injured Christian Ehrhoff. Sutter skates this away for the Penguins and fired in here by Hornquist. Peter Harrell back in the lineup after being a healthy scratch for the last two. Plays this ahead. It deflects out of play. No score in the early going. Devils looking for their first shot.
Tonight's Cold Hard Facts are brought to you by Frost Brewed Coors Light. As we take a look at what the Devils have done in the shootout last year compared to this season, we know the struggles they had last year, Steve. It was epidemic. This year, Not where they want to be quite yet, but it's an improvement. You look at 6 goals compared to 4 last year, but a much higher shooting percentage, a record of 3-6 compared to 0-13 last season. And they made strides in the right direction, especially last game, where I thought the 3 attempts were just spectacular. And you could see a much more relaxed 3 guys that were shooting and really well thought out, made excellent decisions on what they were going to do with the puck on the goaltender burner.
Goal changes the perception of the entire evening, doesn't it? Team flat for 55 minutes, and then they're celebrating a win a little bit later on. Loose puck gathered up here by Harrell. Peter Harrell, nifty little move that's swept away by Fleury. The follow-up try, it's still loose. We have a penalty coming up. It's a hook, and Josephson had the stick knocked out of his hand. Look out.
Well, we got Downey knocked it out of Josephson's hand. Then Jordan Tutu comes to the rescue of his teammate. Those two guys paw at each other. Maybe look down the road here of these two guys possibly going at each other. And here's a good opportunity. Peter Harrell with a nice little move to beat the Penguin winger. Got hooked, was unable to get the shot off. Then Joseph kind of flicks the puck into Fleury after the whistle. Downey didn't like that, but Jordan Tutu says, if you're going to deal with anybody, you're going to have to go through me. And we saw a little bit of this last game between these two teams. Expect Jordan Tutu to be in the middle of it if it gets physical.
Two Penguins going to the penalty box. Maxim LaPierre and Steve Downey, the most penalized player in the National Hockey League. There's Downey.
I like what Jordan Tutu did there. He got the glove to the face from Downey, but he controlled his emotions as he saw the Devils were definitely going on the power play. And all of a sudden, it turns into a two-man advantage. Smart reaction play by Jordan Tutu. There's time if he wants to get back to Downey in this hockey game.
So you asked for an early potential turning point. 5-on-3 for the Devils, and Marek Sedlitsky on the puck here. Works it across. Camilleri is the other point man. Taken here by Zajac. Back to Camilleri. Sedlitsky down low. Patrick Elias holds at the side. Gives to Sedlitsky. The Czech defenseman holds, crosses up, shoots, and that's blocked away in front. Eliash quickly on the loose puck. Taken here by Camilleri. Devils hold the zone nicely. Eliash now under pressure. Gives to Camilleri. Back to Eliash. Devils set up, thrown across. Zajac tries to get a shot away. That's Scuderi who got a stick on it. Kept alive here, and Camilleri will drag it back. Crosses up, play down low. Zajac throws it across. Yager knocked down in the slot. Picked up here by Camilleri as the Penguins can't clear. Here's Zajac again. All pressure time for the Devils. Yager shoots off Paul Martin's stick and deflected out of play.
That was a real nice play by Paul Martin, the former New Jersey Devil in front, getting a stick on Yager, who was right in the high slot with a good scoring chance. You see Mike Camilleri able to keep that puck in when it looked like it was going to get out of the Penguin zone. Zajac to Yager, and Paul Martin stays home right in front to deflect that opportunity. Real good heads-up play from Penguin defenseman Paul Martin.
Zajac wins the draw cleanly. Adam Oates keeping the same 5 on the power play on the ice. Elias shot save made by Fleury. Picked up here by Patrick Elias. 55 to go now in the two-man advantage. Zdlitsky shoots. Oh, what a glove save by Fleury, who's got it.
Marc-Andre Fleury with the beautiful flashing of the letter with the glove save here. These are fun to watch, aren't they, when a goaltender has a beat on it. We know Marek Sedlitsky can really wire the puck, and Marc-Andre Fleury, he had a good sight line on it. But boy, quick with the glove hand there.
This might be a two-minute power play unit. Same 5 remain on here for the Devils. Zajac wins it again from Brandon Sutter. Camilleri works it down low. Zajac for Camilleri. The return pass. Camilleri shoots on the one-timer. He fired it wide. Elias knocked down behind the net. And Letang with a big clear for the Penguins.
First time the puck has left the Penguin zone, but the Penguins doing a good job positioning. Devils not moving the puck quite quick enough, Steve. The Penguins are able to get sticks on a lot of shots and passes. And to me, that's just a little hesitation in some of the passes on the 5-on-3 power play.
Here's Elias motoring ahead for New Jersey. Now works it across. Martin Havlat steps on for the continuation of the two-man advantage. Zajac has it. feathers the puck to Eliash. Patrick Eliash at the circle, holds. 5 seconds to go in the two-man advantage. Taken here by Merrill, played down low. Eliash has it. Two Penguins now emerge from the box, back to even strength. Greg Adams on the puck, and that's a huge kill for Pittsburgh early in the game. Followed up here by LaPierre, and that's fought off by Schneider, who has to cover the rebound in the crease.
Well, missed opportunity by the Devils there, and not very well executed on that power play. Yes, give the Penguins a lot of credit. The three guys that were out there did an excellent job, mostly Letang and Martin on the back end, not giving the Devils many lanes to move that puck, but you need some one-touch passes there and get guys just a little out of position, Steve. You didn't see enough of that on the five-on-three. Devils were not crisp at all on that power play advantage.
So New Jersey with two shots on that five-on-three power play. Gomez will now take the draw against David Perron as Crosby was moved out of the circle. Pittsburgh coming in 3 points behind the first-place Islanders in the Metropolitan Division. They've won just once in the last six. And difficulty here, winning just three of the last 14 at Prudential Center, dating back to 2008-2009. Gomez on the puck here, works it ahead. And it's played here by Bernier, but knocked away from him. Quickly on the puck is Chris Kunitz for Pittsburgh. That's off a stick and deflected out of play. Well, the Penguins' longtime radio broadcaster Mike Lang would often say of Jaromir Jagr and the goaltenders he would face, he beat him like a rented mule. Well, between the years 1995 and 2001, he said it a lot, because five times in those seven seasons, Jagr led the NHL in scoring. You know, for him, this is a bounce-back game tonight. He didn't have a shot against the Maple Leafs on Wednesday.
To be expected, Rusty, like a lot of the Devils, the break, but in particular, Jagr, with 19 days off, haven't played a game, so expect him to take a little time to find his timing as well.
Collected here by the Penguins and shoveled back in deep. Jordan Tutu works at it along the near boards, and he's off to the races. The Churchill Manitoba native able to guide it in deep. Rutu is on the loose puck here. Gloved down by Larson, who fires, and this puck deflects out of play for another stoppage in play.
Devil netminder Corey Schneider has really settled in the last 3 weeks so far here, Steve, where he's really been impressive. 5-1, 9.37 save percentage, and he continues to climb up the ladder statistically as far as National Hockey League goaltenders go, and the one area he wants to climb is wins to help his team continue to try to get their way back into position maybe for a playoff position. But boy, has he been good the last month here.
Last two performances by Corey really have been eye-opening. This is fluttered towards Fleury, who gloves it. 29 saves versus the Leafs, 34 versus San Jose in the game before the break. We'll step aside.
Well, Jaromir Jagr may have led the league in scoring in 1995, but the Devils won the Stanley Cup. And they're going to be celebrating the 20th anniversary of that first Cup team coming up in March. They've announced it as the March 8th game against the Flyers. One of the stars of that team, John McClain, will be with me on the GMC Intermission Report. We'll talk a little bit about that and a lot about this first period, guys.
Thank you, Deb. I know you're looking forward to that tremendously that weekend. The memories that only that group can share. I guess Fred Shiro said, you win games like that, you walk together forever. You understand that, don't you?
I'm really looking forward to seeing that cast of characters. That team was such a fun group, a hard-working group, and to hoist the Stanley Cup for the first time in New Jersey, something special.
Shot by Sutter is saved by Corey Schneider. Sidney Crosby won his second scoring title last season with 104 points, 51 so far this year. That's going to take a lot to eclipse that total down the stretch. No points in his last three. The Penguins have a very good feeling about this top line now with the addition of David Perron. Kunitz compliments him tremendously. What about Perron there, the trade?
Well, David Perron, obviously, with the struggles in Edmonton, it can really wear on a offensive player, a good player like David Perron. All of a sudden, he finds himself traded and on a top line with Sidney Crosby and Chris Kunitz. I mean, how can you not be motivated? And David Perron's done a good job since he's come over from Edmonton.
acquired here by the Devils and taken by Martin Havlat. Havlat dumps in, and Eliash is the man who gives chase here. Bumps with Dupre, who works the puck across, and now Chris Letang shovels it ahead for the Penguins. No score, just over 9 minutes left in this opening period of play. Crosby, first man in deep for the Penguins here. Love down by Eliash and work back towards the point where Kunitz is able to play this ahead. Dupre behind the net. Here's Crosby. Centering try. Kunitz with a shot. Stopped by somebody in front and shoveled away. I'm not sure that got to Corey or not.
Yeah, I think Green or Larson got a piece of that. Again, the Penguins applying all sorts of pressure in the Devils' zone. Let's go back right here. See Sidney Crosby finds Kunitz there. And in fact, it is that man, Adam Larson, who we have talked an awful lot about the last little while. He just seems to be in the right place at the right time as his confidence in game continues to get better and better. You know, going back to David Perron as well, playing with Sidney Crosby, he's a shooter. So I think that's why this could really work for the Penguins. Crosby, you know how good of a passer is, his vision on the ice. David Perron just has to tap that stick and get open, and he could put the puck in the net.
Shot by Merrill, blocked away in front, and trying to sweep at the loose puck was Camilleri, but he couldn't bury that. Taken by Dupre, who works it back out the other way. And Peter Harreld, as icing is waved off, plays this for John Merrill. Here's Zubras on the puck, 2-on-2. He's got Steve Bernier with him. Dynas met at the blue line by the big Robert Bortuzzo, and two big men start jabbing at each other. Maybe four big guys.
We thought this game could be a little bit testy at times. A couple of shoves. And everything settles down there, but Robert Bortuzzo, we know, involved in every matchup the Devils have played, especially with the big hit a while back in Pittsburgh on Jágr and a couple of scraps against Jordan Tootoo last time these two teams met, so you know he's going to be in the middle of it.
Tootoo was telling me that Bortuzzo said to him when the game was 1-0 Penguins last time, if you tie the score, I'll go with you. And Jordan said, no, that's not the deal. This is going to happen, and it's going to happen now. And the Devils went on to win that game. Tootoo was rightfully so one of the three stars that night for New Jersey, as it's fired in by Tuomo Rutsu. Fleury under pressure works the puck away, and here's Tootoo. Neat little pass for Rutsu and broken up by the Penguins. Steve Downey marching back the other way. Here's Downey shooting, and he fired it wide.
Steve Downey had some time and blisters a wrist shot off the right side.
Scuderi works it across, and Paul Martin back to Rob Scuderi. Two-time cup winner is the 35-year-old Scuderi with Pittsburgh in 09, with the LA Kings in 2012. Worked ahead, Scott Gomez on the move here. He's got the fellow veteran Scuderi there with him. Jágr on the follow-up for New Jersey. Gives it back to Gomez. Scott Gomez centering try. Jágr got a stick on it, and the puck shoveled away wide. Gomez works it back to the point. Fraser wrist shot blocked away by Fleury. Picked up here by Henry. He can play it into the corner. Here's Jágr coming out of traffic with it. Now drops for Gomez. Tried to feed Henrik on the one-timer. Devils control anyway. Zidlitsky tries to throw one in front. Penguins are filling the lanes here, but it goes behind the net for Henrik. Punched back towards the point and taken here by Fraser. He'll guide it back in deep. Gomez trying to shake loose of Scuderi. Got the puck loose to Jágr, and he shot it wide. Good pressure by this unit. Zidlitsky goes for the neat move down low. Broken up by Pittsburgh and taken here by Zidlitsky again. And look out. Broken up by Brandon Sutter, who's in on a break. He shoots. Big save by Corey Schneider.
Wow. What a save by Corey Schneider on Brandon Sutter. On the breakaway, Devils are getting a penalty here now.
Fleury to the bench. Pittsburgh quickly gets the extra attacker on, and that extra attacker is Crosby. Broken up by Jágr. No whistle yet. Jágr heads to the bench, and Dupre keeps this alive for Chris Letang. Here's Letang working it back for Crosby. Delayed penalty against New Jersey. Letang comes off the boards with it. And with that touch by Fraser, we'll step aside. We'll set up the Penguins' first power play of the night when we come back.
Devils applying their best best pressure of the period down low. You see Zidlitsky, the defenseman, down low. Adam Henrique does a real good job of covering his spot, but the puck ends up not getting to Adam Henrique, and he's kind of over to the middle of the ice, and Brandon Sutter off to the races. He picks Zidlitsky's pass off to Henrique, and on a breakaway, Corey Schneider, nowhere to go. Sutter tries to go five hole. Schneider's been excellent so far in the first period. There, in front of the net, we see the Devils go to the penalty box. That's Mark Frazier. Penguins on the power play.
Brandon Sutter is one of the most dangerous players in the league shorthanded as Crosby fires that wide. He scored twice shorthanded already this season on breakaways. That wasn't a shorthanded situation, but nevertheless, in on Schneider and the big stop. Pittsburgh power play ranked sixth in the National Hockey League entering play tonight. Great one hand on the stick clearance by Josephson to work it out of the zone. And here's Kunitz right back into the Devil's end. Zubris there to meet Crosby, and it's broken up again. Chris Letang taken here by Pittsburgh. Third leading scorer among NHL defensemen is Chris Letang. Harold works it free to the stick of Camilleri. Able to bank it out of the zone, and now Zubris trying to kill more time at center ice. Good start to this penalty kill for New Jersey.
The Devils not giving the Penguins any time to them space through the neutral zone to get into the Devils' end. In fact, they have to dump it in. Devils are able to get it right back out so far early in this penalty kill.
Crosby works it across, played here to the stick of Steve Downey, and whisked away by Elias.
A slick little play by the old veteran Patrick Elias, staying in position and picking that pass off.
37 to go in the power play for Pittsburgh. Sent into the Devil's end. Downey is giving chase. Bumps with John Merrill. Here's Green. Sends it around the boards. Picks up Patrick Elias, who gets ahead of steam going. Broken up. That's Sutter back checking from behind. And taken here by Brandon Sutter again. Sutter over the line. Puts the brakes on. Works it and gets it back from Paul Martin. They feed Dupre. That shot saved by Schneider. It's loose, and the puck worked back to Dupre at the point. Holds the zone for Pittsburgh and now dishes off. Taken here by Mark Arcabello and played down low. Arcabello again. Out of the box is Frazier. Big save by Schneider on the shot by Simone Dupre. Back to five on five. Dupre again. That's blocked by Tuomo Ruotsu. Taken by Martin. Sutter fires. Saved by Schneider. He stopped 12 Penguin shots already in the game. Collected again by Pittsburgh. Downey with a shot and a pad save again by Corey Schneider.
It's the Corey Schneider show here in the first period. Great instinct of saves.
LaPierre behind the net. Can't find the handle. Instead, lifted away by Scott Gomez.
One in particular, Steve, from the point where it went through a maze of traffic, and Corey Schneider, the last second, was able to kick out the right pad.
Take it here, Bortuzzo, and steered into the zone by Zach Sill. He is seeing the puck. Is that an indication of lateral movement that we're seeing by Corey that's as good as it's been?
Well, you're zoned in, you're confident in Corey Schneider. We've seen that the last couple of weeks, as we've been talking about.
Sill tries to get a shot away, broken up and lifted away by Henry.
Although I think the Devils would like to pick it up a little bit for him and not make it about Corey Schneider right now. Penguins really have dominated this first period.
Patrick Hornquist on the puck for Pittsburgh. Guides this back. Harrington is able to send it in deep. John Merrill trying to stick handle away. He could not. Zubris comes over to help. Shields a Penguin away from the puck. That man, Nick Spaulding, and played by Pittsburgh again at center. 2:15 to go, opening period, as Andrew Ebbett will dump in. Here's Zubris. Works it to center. Camilleri trying to find the handle, but the bouncing puck taken instead by Zach Sill. David Perron able to work this ahead, and Ebbett punches it into the Devil's end. Kunitz on the puck for Pittsburgh, tied up by John Merrill, and Zubris there to help to work it away. Pass by Larson, intercepted by Crosby. What's been an excellent first period for the Penguins so far, but no goals to show. You wonder if that has an effect at some point.
Well, they were shut out in Washington you think now the Penguins are pressing a little bit. However, they have had some quality chances. And regardless, Devils have to be better and change the tide here a little bit.
Green works it ahead. Sent wide of Fleury's goal. It's icing against the Devils.
Look at some of the work of Corey Schneider. Penguins on the power play. Danny right in front. There's Dupre with the shot from the point. Hits a pad and goes to the left, doesn't quite get to Schneider. And there you see Andy Green blocks it, but Downey able to get that puck, and he just sticks out the right pad save there. Downey didn't get a whole lot on that one, but earlier on, there was one in particular from the point where he really had to come up big to keep this game scoreless.
Zajac and LaPierre on the draw. It's won by the Penguins, and again, Corey Schneider put to the test on the shot by Simone Dupre. Loose puck, now Letang tries to fire away, and Green able to block that. Minute to go in the opening period. Devils might be happy to get to the locker room here as it's worked across to Adam Larson. Shot disparity is 14-4 in favor of the Penguins to this point. Chris Letang holding behind his net. Here's Scuderi for the Penguins. Has to flex off the stick of Andrew Ebbett and taken instead by Henry. Here's Jágr stepping on. First 11 seasons of this Hall of Fame career spent in a Penguins uniform, starting with back-to-back cup championships. Gomez is over the line here for the Devils. Able to send it in deep. Fraser collides with Craig Adams. Punched away by Martin, and it popped over the stick of Adam Henry.
Good job by Mark Fraser. Pinching there, it was the right time. Took a big hit from Craig Adams, but puck just bounces over Adam Henrik's stick, and they get a scoring chance.
And with that, period one comes to an end. 14 of the 18 shots by the Penguins. The GMC first intermission report looks back at 95. Get your friends together and head to Prudential Center for a Devils game. Purchase a girls and guys night out package, which includes your ticket, a hot dog, and either a beer or a soda. To purchase your girls and guys night out ticket package, visit NewJerseyDevils.com/nightout or call 1-800-NJ-DEVIL. There's one guy in this game from Ferris State, and that's the Penguins' Chris Kunitz. The Bulldogs, they are. And back in 2003, he helped put the program on the map. He was the CCHA Player of the Year and the Bulldogs' first ever trip to the NCAA tournament. They were 31-10-1 that year, the best record in school history. And they've stayed relatively close to the top. Only last spring, he was celebrating a trip to the Elite Eight by Ferris State. They were eliminated in double overtime by North Dakota, which probably made a man by the name of Travis Zajac quite happy. Kunitz had the advantage, as a lot of players do, of playing two full seasons in the AHL. We forget sometimes, Travis went practically straight from college to the National Hockey League. He had two games for the Albany River Rats mixed in between. How hard is that?
Well, it's very difficult for anyone, but for a college player, you're a little more mature. You're in your 20s, 20, 21 years old, so you've filled out a little bit more. And from a physical standpoint, I think you might be a little more ready than an 18-year-old kid coming out of junior.
And Travis will remind you that North Dakota is number one in the country right now. Second period underway. See if the Devils have a little bit more in their arsenal here, as they were outshot 14-4 in the first, and it's taken here by Paul Martin. Brandon Sutter, one of the best scoring chances of the opening period for Pittsburgh, battles with Mark Fraser along the near boards for the loose puck. Here's Gomez sending it in.
You mentioned Devils in the first period, not a lot of scoring opportunities. The Penguins had most of the territorial play in the puck as well. Devils had the 1-5-on-3, which wasn't very successful.
Offside is the call here against Pittsburgh.
We talked a lot about Adam Larson lately and his countryman from Sweden, Jacob Josephson, 11:07 last game of ice time, and scored the game winner in the shootout. He just looks so calm and relaxed. Shows me he's growing in confidence as well. We talked so much about how Larson's playing well. Now maybe, just maybe, Josephson can continue to follow this up. Some nights he's not going to play a whole lot of minutes. 11's not bad, but he's got to be prepared for that. And I think he's feeling a little bit better about his game. So do the Devils.
Jacob Josephson, a shorthanded goal in the game just before the break. a shootout win. And a shootout goal in the game right after the break. Lou Lamoriello says for him, it is all about consistency. When he finds that, no doubt, as Kunitz's shot goes wide of goal, that Josephson's an everyday NHL player. Worked out the center here, and Kunitz is able to guide this back for Dupre. Penguins quickly gain the zone again. Perron trying to feed Crosby, but it goes off his stick. Sidney Crosby caught in a little bit tight. Larson leaves this.
Little tight and a little bit of a hard pass from Perron, but when Sidney Crosby is playing his best, he picks that puck up regardless. And right now you mentioned a little bit of a slump for Sidney Crosby, and also coming back from injury as well.
Skip the All-Star festivities, as Deb told you in the pregame, and then it was mandatory because of that he missed at least one game. Crosby said that was not a league thing. He needed time off after the break. Shot from the point is blocked away. That's Bernier who got in the way of Harrington's shot, and it's lifted away again. Icing this time is waved off. Here's Bortuzzo back for the Penguins. Nearly given away to Bernier. And taken back by the Penguins. 37-year-old Craig Adams. Hartford Whalers draft pick many moons ago into the Devil's end. Camilleri now back the other way. Here's Dinah Zubras over the line, able to dish across, and Bernier will send it in deep. 2.5 minutes in the period two. We're scoreless at the Rock. Devils trying to collect a third straight win for the first time since the season's opening week. Zubras tries to lay this off for Camilleri. Now the shot from the point by Harold blocked away, and coming back the other way for the Penguins. Sill with a shot, and he fired it wide.
Zach Sill whistled one. I think John Merrill got a little piece of that, deflect that up and over Corey Schneider.
Martin winds it around the boards and taken here by Adams again. Greg Adams into the Devil's end where Marek Zidlitsky controls here. He's hit by Adams, and the puck worked out to center.
And the way this game is going, Steve, it's Penguins are really moving their feet, moving the puck. I always talk about you need to disrupt something here. Maybe get a little physical from the Devils so that they slow the Penguins down somewhat in some capacity, maybe big hits.
Crosby's centering try is broken up.
And I don't condone fighting always, but if that's available, even a scrap, you got to slow the pace down here a little bit as the Penguins are really coming. You expected that after their outing in Washington wasn't very good.
Kunitz's backhander goes wide. There's Martin sending it right back in. Crosby takes it off the boards. Here's Crosby. Backhand try. Save made by Schneider as he got the pad down.
Corey Schneider, again, unbelievable save on Sidney Crosby. He's got one of the best backhand shots in the National Hockey League.
Eliash crosses up with Havlat deep in the Penguin zone. And Crosby collecting here. He is tied for fourth in scoring in the National Hockey League, Sidney Crosby. 51 points coming into tonight as Andy Green winds it around. Henrik waiting for it. Paul Martin there to deal with him, and Fleury works it away. Patrick Hornquist on the move, 2-on-2. Nick Spaulding is with him. Hornquist centering try. They had Spaulding tied up nicely, and back come the Devils. Gomez, though, has a pass picked off by Sutter. Gomez for Adam Henry. Works it across, and here's Jaromir Jagr over the line. Lost control of the puck. Harrington there to seal him off, and it's taken away by Pittsburgh again. Opening 5 minutes of the second period. Batted down with a high stick by Harold, and that will stop play.
Take a look at the Sidney Crosby scoring chance there. You see him come out of the corner, get himself in good position right in front of Corey Schneider, and a quick backhand shot right here. We're going to take a look. Schneider tries to go back the other way with it, but Corey again in the butterfly makes the right pad save and kicks that puck out. Schneider has been terrific in this hockey game, 25 minutes in.
Off the draw, it's taken here by Harold. Eric Gelinas is sitting this one out for the Devils tonight as Harold comes back into the lineup. Devils starting their 11th set of back-to-back games this season. They play 18 of those sets this year total. Here's Harold with a shot. Glove save, Marc-Andre Fleury, who holds on. Tonight's trivia question is brought to you by our good friends from Cadillac. Before Marc-Andre Fleury, who was the last Penguins goaltender with 25 or more wins in a season.
Let's see.
I have many educated guesses.
Marc-Andre Fleury came into the league in...
first overall pick in 2003, and played shortly after that.
So we got to go back a little bit. He's been around a while.
Here's Letang dishing off. Steve Downey works it across. Oh, that came up high on Peter Harrell, who punches it away to the stick of Dinah Zubris. Don't know if we have to go all the way back to the likes of Michel Dion, do we?
Who I happened to score my first National Hockey League goal on, Steve, way back in 1983. A lot of people here probably are listening, haven't even heard of Michel Dion, but he was a pretty good goaltender back then.
Pittsburgh Penguins had a couple of good ones leading up to Marc-Andre Fleury. Now, Tom Barrazzo is the one that immediately comes
to
mind.
Well, in their heyday when the Penguins, and they're still in their heyday, but when they were winning Stanley Cups with the great Mario Lemieux.
Offside are the Penguins here. Barrazzo was something special when he was 19 and playing in the NHL. This guy has been something special for 17 seasons, and that's Patrick Elias, who continues that elusive chase for 400. He scored 399 January 6th. Now, this is only a five-game drought, and Patrick actually does have 8 points in his last 8 games. You brought this up last game a bit. He insists he does not fret when chasing milestones. He's very comfortable as long as he's comfortable with the way he's playing, and he doesn't seem disturbed by this weight. At least not yet.
Well, you've been around as long as Patrick has and have the experience he does. You know it's coming eventually. However, I still feel you'd like to get it out of the way sooner than later.
Adams sends this in, and it's taken by Corey Schneider.
Work. Sorry, Steve. I think more importantly for Patrick Elias is it's a big goal. It comes at the right time, like a game right now where the Devils are being outplayed, maybe, but still only a 0-0 hockey game.
Here's David Perron over the line collecting for Pittsburgh. Zajac able to take that away from him, and Larson punches it ahead. Martin Havlat able to chip that back into the Penguins' end where Scuderi is giving chase. Congratulations to Martin Havlat. Welcome to baby daughter into the world. Yesterday, Nicola is the newest New Jersey Devils fan. Picked up here and taken by Havlat. In the corner, number 9 for New Jersey. Sees it checked away by Chris Kunitz. Puck taken away by Elias instead. Here's Patrick Elias, tries to feed Havlat. Elias got a shot away and a save by Fleury.
Well, we almost saw it right there, the 400.
Taken away by Havlat, and Fleury's got that as well. Marc-Andre Fleury facing a Fleury for the first time tonight.
Best scoring chance of the hockey game for the New Jersey Devils, and it comes from the stick of Patrick Elias as he tries to pass. Scuderi blocks it, comes right back to him. He gets a great opportunity, and then Marty Havlat on the turnover from Crosby. Let's go back to Patrick's chance. Acrobatic save by Fleury, had to get across. Patrick, wish he got that up a little bit more. Puck was on end, but good chance. And we talked about his 400th that almost just came right there.
That's the Fleury that we've seen for most of the regular season. I know he's had that dry spell in the last 6. This trickle score, Schneider, he has to make another big save, and he covers up with Hornquist at the doorstep.
Again, Corey Schneider. Tricky shot here as it's along the ice and just deflected off of a Devil's skate, it looked like. He's able to find that puck. Boy, you talked about him tracking the puck, Steve. That's Spaulding there. You see it goes through a maze of people. That's not always easy. You see Sutter, Fraser in front, but he gets the left pad out, and then the rebound doesn't go too far so he can cover it up. He's just really in the zone, isn't he? I mean, this is the best stretch we've seen Corey Schneider as a New Jersey Devil. Real focused here and has kept this game scoreless.
Sutter chased out, Spaulding steps in, and the Penguins win the draw back. Here's Martin with a shot, and it's another save by Corey Schneider, his 17th of the night. We're 7.5 into period 2 as the puck comes back, and it's taken here by Fraser, under pressure from Sutter. Jarred the puck loose, and the Penguins following up here. Now Gomez works it free to the stick of Jaromir Jagr. Gomez darts into the Penguin zone. Gomez lost his edge, and now Jagr on the opposite side. Here's Henrique. Punches it out of midair, and Scuderi will play this ahead for the Penguins. Still scoreless. That was the theme for the longest time here, two nights ago. The Devils wound up beating the Maple Leafs. There were no goals scored until the 11:49 mark of the third. Let's see how long it takes tonight as Gomez fires in.
Pittsburgh Penguins really taking the body, finishing their checks at every turn. You saw Lapierre, who just recently came over from St. Louis. We know he'll do that. Downey. The Penguins are really finishing their checks, and when I see a team do that, they're not happy with their play. They want to make sure they take care of the little things first and play a much more sound game, and hitting is part of that.
Penalty coming up here. Zubras had his arms draped around Dupre, and let's see, the call is a hold.
Man, Zubras not happy about the call. You see right here, Zubras behind the net on Dupre. I mean, he's got a little bit of a case there. We've seen Zubras take these kinds of penalties in the offensive zone too often. Well, that's a little too much, Steve. You got to let go. We know you're going to call it, especially when Dupre has the position on him. Not a penalty you want to take in the offensive zone, and Penguins go back on the power play.
Pittsburgh power play tonight, 0-for-1. One shot on that first opportunity. Devils start by winning a draw and sending it the length of the ice. Zajac and Josephson, the penalty killers to start with Adam Larson and Andy Green. On the move here for Pittsburgh is Chris Letang. Weaves his way into the Devils' zone and works it across. Now Kunitz lost control of the puck. Letang keeps it moving, and Crosby covering the blind point now has it on the half court. Sidney Crosby, they work it across, shot by Letang, save made by Schneider on the rebound, punch wide. Kunitz keeps it alive, and Crosby plays it back to the point. Perron for Crosby. Penguins set it up. David Perron at the point, able to control, and now works it across. Penguins captain Crosby will take it off the boards and play it back. Here's Letang. Return pass. Now Crosby works it back to Letang. He shoots. Saved by Schneider through traffic. Loose at the doorstep, trying to jam it on Hornquisty. Now Letang follows up. Broken up by Zajac and punched out of the zone.
This is some kind of goaltending display from Devil netminder Corey Schneider. And Travis Zajac finally relieves the pressure with a real good stick to get the puck out of the zone. Penguins zipping that puck around. We know they're very capable of that with the likes of Crosby, Letang.
Devils got the opportunity to get fresh legs on at the forward position as Camilleri stepped on with Elias. Patrick Elias now shorthanded for the Devils. Will head for the bench. Short shift for that duo, and taken here by Paul Martin. 20 seconds to go on this Penguins power play. Six-year Devil Paul Martin fires into the zone. Following up, Mark Arcavella. Lost control. Spalling works it back to Prey. Got a shot away, but that's blocked away by Henrique. Loose behind the net. Battling for it, John Merrill. Arcavella works it back to the point. Here's Martin across. Dupre is on the puck. Works it ahead. Spalling can't control. Taken away by Henrique. Out of the box is Zubras. And we're back to 5-on-5. Three shots. That was an excellent Penguins power play, but no goal to show for it.
Again, the best penalty killer on the ice, the Devils goaltender Corey Schneider.
Picked up here by Jágr. Zubras leaves this for Gomez. Here's Scott Gomez. Centering try, and that's broken up by Pittsburgh. Jágr tries to control and now gets it back from Dina Zubras. Funneled behind the net. Gomez centering try. Looking for Jágr in front, but that's broken up. Gomez again tries to nurse it back to the point. The Penguins play this to the stick of Zach Sill. 8.5 to go. Pittsburgh out shooting New Jersey 20-7, but we remain scoreless. Schneider has been superb again. 2-2 delivers ahead. Puck freed up. Gomez tried to work it across for the cutting Tuomo Ruutu. Broken up by the Penguins again. You get the feeling if it's going to happen for the Devils, it's going to come off a bounce, a redirection, or something. Pittsburgh has been pretty good in its own end here, Dan.
They really have, and I think the only difference and what we're seeing from the Penguins is they're on the puck a little quicker. It's always that half step, and they just haven't given the Devils a whole lot of room to work when they do get the puck in the Penguins' end, and that hasn't been too often.
Stripped away by Green. Here's Adam Larson on the puck. Not out of the zone. Scuderi's shot is blocked away and taken by Larson again. He takes a hit from Kunitz, and the Devils work it out to center. Robert Bortuzzo on the puck. Works it ahead. Here's Perron. Nifty pass to Crosby. Goes into the corner and controls. Sidney Crosby funnels it across. Collected here by Perron again. That shot is fired away wide. Now Bortuzzo at the point. Works it across. Scuderi's was shot. Redirected and it went wide. Penguins buzzing again. Here's Crosby at the circle. Plays it across. Broken up. That's Rutu who got a stick on it. But Kunitz has the puck. So much pressure by Pittsburgh. Scuderi has got it. Gives to Crosby. Fakes the shot. Now fires. Block a save by Schneider. Loose in the slot. Corey Schneider's got it again.
Just a clinic. As we see a little pushing and shoving in front. Pittsburgh is buzzing. Penguins on the power play. All kinds of time. Move the puck. Good save by Schneider again on the rebound. Hornquist right there. And then a little help from the goalpost. Sidney Crosby on the backhand. Hits the right post on the far side. And boy, look at Hornquist there. Puck bouncing all over the place. Again, you see a maze of bodies in front. Schneider's able to find that and cover it up. And he has been spectacular, Steve. Yes, he got some help from the post there, but it just seems he's in the right position. He's finding the puck. And he's getting too much work as far as the Devils are concerned.
Do you think he saw that shot on the blocker save through the screen, or is that just feel?
It's feel and instinct. Sometimes you're not going to see pucks, but when you're in the zone and playing as well as Corey Schneider is, those things seem to find a way to hit you.
And it remains a scoreless game. Brandon Sutter on the puck for Pittsburgh, right back on the offensive of the Penguins. Peter Harrell tied up behind his own goal. Hornquist going for the takeaway, shoveled one ahead and taken here by Letang. Chris Letang to the stick of Brandon Sutter. Knocked down on the play, and the Penguins have to retreat.
You don't see Sidney Crosby miss an open net, even though he's at a sharp angle too often. Think the puck was on edge a little bit, but he couldn't believe he didn't put that in.
Down, he lost control of the puck. Here's Zubras off the feed from Havlat, and the Devils are offside. Tonight's Geico hometown hero is Charlie Cunningham from Wayne Township, New Jersey. Charlie is a 50-year veteran of the Wayne Township Fire Company No. 2. He served in every firematic officer position in the department, including chief and commissioner. Charlie Cunningham, thank you. You're our hometown hero tonight. 50 years. Do we have a shot?
Well, that's a heck of a lot of service, and congrats to Charlie.
Zubras on the puck here for the Devils. Worked across, and here's Camilleri on the move. Mike Camilleri throws it across, the redirection by Zubras. Just missed. Back the other way come the Penguins, and LaPierre is on the move here. Ridden into the boards by Fraser. They punch it back to the point. Taken here by Bortuzzo, who funnels it in deep for Pittsburgh. Under 6 minutes to go, second period. Remains scoreless, the Devils and Penguins meeting for the fourth time this year. Devils trying to even the season series at two. LaPierre twisting in the Devils' end. Camilleri now. There to tie up his man and rough and tumble Steve Downey. Now Zidlitsky gets a piece of it. Downey on the puck again in the corner. The ex-Flyer tried to work it ahead. Bernier will lift it away.
You mentioned the Devils trying to even the season series up. The Penguins have really struggled in the conference under 500. In fact, I think they're 9-2 against the West, against the powerful West. So there's a little inconsistency, and yes, some of the injuries that they have had all season long.
How about this? They're 1-4-2 in their last seven road games overall, and road games within the division, 1-5-3. The Devils have been part of that.
Playing much better tonight, but nothing to show for it yet.
Hey, guys, I'm at ice level here, and, you know, seeing the Pittsburgh zone here, they're moving the puck. They're supporting very well down here. They're moving the puck, bang, bang, and then they're stretching the zone. They got their wingers up at the far blue line. They're moving the puck up. The Devils aren't able to sustain any pressure down here. They're just moving the puck. They're a little quicker to it right now. So they're going to have to get their five-on-five play and a little more support with their puck offensively, because Pittsburgh defensively supporting it tremendously, putting the puck to the middle of the ice and moving it right up right into the Devils zone. The passing's been great by the Pittsburgh tonight.
John, thank you. And at the end, that's frustrating. No goals, 4:57 left in the second.
And it can be frustrating when you're chasing the puck all night, and that's what's happened so far in this hockey game. And how do you change that? The Devils, how do they change that? And I think the way the Penguins are playing with Ryan Tagliabue, you've got to get those soft dumps in and get the sport. Two guys on the puck. We're just only seeing one guy, and the Penguins like this get the puck out very easily.
Picked up in the Devils' end by John Merrill. Lost his edge, but plenty of time to recover. Here's Merrill skating it ahead. Scott Gomez on with Jágr and Henry. Here's the ex-Penguin Jágr looking for space, broken up by the stick of Chris Kunitz. Able to enter the play is Andy Green, who sends it back in. Collected by the stick of Chris Kunitz, who works it ahead. Kunitz following up here. Larson will get on the puck for New Jersey. 4 minutes to go in the second as Henrique works it ahead. Picks up Travis Zajac, who comes on. Havlat and Elias join him. Crashing the net is Martin Havlat. It's off the mooring for a stoppage in play. This spring, Broadway's biggest spectacular is at Radio City Music Hall. The New York Spring Spectacular stars the Rockettes. March 12th through May 3rd. Visit Rockettes.com/spring. I'm told it's going to be 5 degrees out next week, so we're looking forward to the Spring Spectacular, all of us.
Is that warm? Warmer than it has been, shall I say?
There's a chill in the arena here and outside. Faceoff comes outside the Penguin zone as the Devil knock the net off the mooring. Camilleri and Sutter to take the draw. Hornquist able to guide this back, and that's Dupre who sends it into the Devil's end. Icing is waved off. Sutter tries to shake loose of Mike Camilleri. Fraser guides it around the boards. Dupre sends it right back in deep for Pittsburgh. Here's Brandon Sutter, son of the ex-Devils head coach. Now Letang on the puck here for Pittsburgh. Here's Sutter. Turn, shoots off the skate of Mark Fraser. Letang on the follow-up for Pittsburgh. Sends it behind goals. Zidlitsky battling, and Fraser got rid of it quickly to the stick of Bernier. Here's Mark Fraser able to send the puck in Zubra's direction, but that's all. Taken here by Zidlitsky. Eric Zidlitsky off the boards. He'll lead the attack himself, and Letang slow to up with a nice hit.
Yeah, a real nice play by Chris Letang separating Zidlitsky from the puck. Doesn't fish at the puck, just takes the man, and he took him relatively hard as well. That's something Chris Letang, not a big guy, but he can do. He takes the body. He's a strong man on his feet.
Speaking of, Jordan Tutu able to gain the zone. Now Josephson sealed off nicely in the Devil's end by LaPierre. Here's Maxime LaPierre backhanding it in. Pittsburgh wanted to add some toughness with LaPierre. They've reconstructed this team a bit since that second round elimination at the hands of the Rangers last season. Mike Johnston was telling us this morning that one area they have changed. They feel they're a bit more of a physical team and more well-equipped for that time of year. The most well-equipped man in the building tonight has been Corey Schneider. These are the goalies with 40 or more games played this year. Schneider leads them all. Holtby got to 42 with that win over the Penguins last time out. Kari Lehtinen, Frederik Andersen, Tuukka Rask, and Jonathan Quick, that's all. So playing time, an issue for him in his career for so long, is no more. And that's reflective in his play here. Crosby centers the puck. It got by everyone.
Yeah, Corey Schneider, I don't know if he expected this kind of work when he was taking over for the legendary Mark Tambroder, but he's getting a lot of it and performing at such a high level right now. And in particular, this hockey game.
Crosby behind the net. Crosses up with Kunitz, who has the puck, tries to send it into the slot. Collected instead by Perron. David Perron centering try off the stick of Andy Green, and out of the zone it goes. Just over a minute and a half to go in the period, but Kunitz right back into the Devils' end. Gives to Perron. Crosby had it knocked off his stick by Zajac. Back come the Devils. They've got a 3-on-2 if they hurry. Henrique is over the line. Gives here. Larson shoots and he fired it wide. Odd man rush for the Devils. Haven't seen it a lot tonight. Taken here by Gomez.
That odd man rush was created because Adam Larson, again, we talk about him getting more confident. He jumped in the play and made that a 3-and-2, and he took a real good hard wrist shot that just whistled wide.
Taken away by Andrew Evan here for the Penguins. Centering try, and that just missed with Downey heading for the net. Check that. That was Craig Adams in front for Pittsburgh. The connection didn't go. Final minute of period number two. Taken by Letang and sent right back into the Devils' zone. They have weathered the storm to this point. Collected by Jágr. See if the Devils can get something going on this final shift of the period. Larson to the stick of John Merrill. Chased back by Hornquist, and now ahead for Henrik. Broken up by Letang, who sends it right back the other way. Zdlitsky back, icing against the Penguins. The Devils will have a dozen seconds to work with it.
Just saw Penguin defenseman Chris Letang with a nice hit on Marek Zdlitsky a little bit earlier. There you see 12 points in his last seven games. Talked about in the opening, the five-point game in Winnipeg, five assists against the Jets in a victory. Chris Letang is becoming that elite defenseman we're so used to seeing again, and had some setbacks injury-wise, but boy, oh boy, is he playing at the top of his game right now.
Last chance for Zdlitsky. Took something off the shot, and let's see what we have. There's a penalty coming up, and look out in front of the Penguins' net.
Well, we got a big scrum. And Dinas Zubras went back at Letang with a vicious check in front of the net. I don't think he got his stick up too high, but he got him right in the chest. He was not happy about something in front. Chris Letang might have poked at his knee or something with his stick or legs. Let's take a look at the replay. Not much time left here. Devils get a chance there. You see Havlet hook. Letang gives Zubras a couple of shots, and Dinas Zubras comes back at him. So that's just two guys battling.
80 jersey, 2 minutes for
cross check. Both go off for coincidental minors, a slash and cross check. And I like to see this every once in a while, Steve. Shows the competitiveness and what's at stake. Both teams playing hard.
Now you want the game to continue. 3 seconds left in the period. So it evens out in the end. The shots 20-7. In the hockey game in favor of Pittsburgh. And we'll see 4-on-4 for the start, likely, of period number three. Seems to face off a formality with 3.8 seconds to go in the period. Zajac will take it against Brandon Sutter, the best for each side. 40 minutes in the books, and for the second straight time at Prudential Center, it is scoreless after period two. The second intermission report. The Maven with Deb and Johnny Mack. It's all straight ahead. The New Jersey Devils are set to honor the 1995 Stanley Cup championship team in a pregame ceremony on March 8th. Celebrate with a special three-game ticket pack, which includes a commemorative T-shirt for each seat purchased. A limited number of individual game tickets to the March 8th game are also available. For more information, visit NewJerseyDevils.com/95night. The weekend of March 7th and 8th will be very special for my partner, Ken Danico, part of that Devils first championship team, part of all three for that matter. And if our guess is right, might be the first time we see Marty Brodeur in this building since his big announcement yesterday. And I know you're one of those who felt the celebration, whatever tributes are to be had, you should be here.
Yeah, oh, definitely should have been. Should be here. But I'm looking forward to it. According to everybody, Marty's certainly going to be a part of it and be able to take time out for a couple of days. So I just can't wait to see all the guys. You mentioned it. You always have a special bond with guys you work so hard, blood, sweat, and tears to win a championship. That's what it's all about when you're a professional athlete. You want to win. And I, for one, and I know a few guys, are so important. There's Scotty Stevens, our captain and leader, and who was devastating in 95 playoffs with the big hits, none bigger than the one on Kozlov. in Detroit in the Stanley Cup Finals, which kind of was the time I knew we were going to win the Stanley Cup. Scott Stevens set the tempo and tone, but to win it here in New Jersey, the first pro team to win a championship, and that made me very proud. I haven't been in Jersey for so long, and I know it made a lot of the guys proud. It'd be great to see everybody.
And because of number four, the phrase, you're next, gets used a lot around here. Third period is underway. The ex-Devil, Paul Martin, sees it picked off here by Travis Zajac. Good recovery by Rob Scuderi. And the back check here as it's taken away by David Perron. You're the Devils. Adam Oates, Scott Stevens, Lou Lamoriello. What did you want to enforce? Getting out shot, but the game is scoreless.
So, guys, we got to work a little harder. We got to move our feet. It seems like the Devils have been standing still. Now, the Pittsburgh Penguins at times have...
Crosby in, puts the brakes on. Pick up on that in a moment, Dano, as Crosby follows up here and bumps with his own teammate, Perron. Sidney Crosby, strong on the puck, plays it back to Scuderi. Save made, and Schneider holds on.
Hey, what I was going to say, the Penguins have made them look a half-step slow because they played a real good game with nothing to show for it. And there you see Lamoriello and Coach Oates there. And I would think also, guys, we've got to get some pucks in the Penguins zone and get some pressure and get shots. Fire from anywhere. Yes, you haven't played a great game through 40 minutes. Pittsburgh has outplayed you. Your goaltender's giving you a chance to win. So go play 20 minutes hard. You got a chance to get something out of this game.
This is the third time in the last seven games the Devils had fewer than 10 shots through two periods. It's an alarming trend, but some results have been there. Good results mixed in that stretch. Dupre sends it in front. Oh, Schneider got the leg out. It's loose in the crease, and then Ronald behind the net, and as all players get back to their feet, the Devils come back the other way with a 3-on-2. Here's Zidlitsky, works it ahead. Havlat got a stick on it, but it went wide. Hornquist now, a 3-on-2 for the Penguins the other way. Drops it for Dupre. Blocker saved. The follow-up try went wide.
Well, I think Zidlitsky got a stick on that. That was an open net on the rebound for Kunitz. We got some good action, 4-on-4, things opening up.
Here's Havlat shooting, blocked away by Fleury. Picked up here by Larson, plays it across. One-timer by Green, punched away and swept out of the crease at the last moment. Simone Dupre helping the goaltender, Marc-Andre Fleury.
That deflected off Patrick Elias, and again, he comes close to breaking the scoreless tie and getting his 400th goal.
Picked up by Spaulding. In the Devils' end, drops it back. Scuderi shot blocked away. Scott Gomez got in the way of that. And Green is on the puck here. Here's Gomez trying to punch it ahead. Nearly taking that away was Downey, but it comes to Schneider instead.
Oh, here you see Dupre in front to Hornquist. Corey Schneider holds his ground as he's mauled in front by Zidlitsky. See again. Nice little give and go. Hornquist goes hard in the net like he should. But Corey Schneider has denied everything the Pittsburgh Penguins have thrown at him. And there you see Patrick Elias. I think it hit his pant leg and sat in the crease. Looked like it might have went in the net except for Simone Dupre clearing it right from the crease.
Comes back to Scott Harrington. The rookie defenseman gives here to Arcabello. And the shot is blocked away in front by Mark Fraser. Harrington is back. It's icing against the Devils. Let's take it back to the Cadillac trivia question and answer time. Before Fleury, who was the last Penguins goaltender with 25 or more wins in one season? I'm going to give it my best shot, Tom Barrazzo. Dano?
I was going Tom Barrazzo as well, but I think there is somebody else in that gap there that I'm missing.
There was a Devils connection as we see another save made by Schneider off the stick of Letang. Moose Hedberg. I should learn my lesson by now.
Johan Hedberg, the Moose. That's right. He did go there and play very well for...
Sent in front and trickled away from Corey Schneider's crease. Crosby behind the net. Penguins are buzzing again, and that pass is broken up. Perron right back to the stick of Sidney Crosby. Crosby knocked down by Fraser. Tries to beat Schneider on the wraparound try on the backhand. Schneider had none of it. Letang is on the puck here. Feathers it across. Now Kunitz plays this to Harrington's stick. Harrington tries to throw it in front. Broken up by the Devils. Right off the bench, Arcabello firing, and that's blocked away wide. A surge again by Pittsburgh. Perron works it across. Harrington shot off Arcabello in front, who tracks it down. Arcabello to the stick of Perron. Tried to play it back to Harrington. Broken up. Back the other way come the Devils. Camilleri can only go so far with it, and taken here by Downey instead. Steve Downey. Cross-ice pass. Hornquist shot blocked away by Schneider again.
Penguins shooting from everywhere as well, feeling that they've had so many chances. Just keep firing away.
Yager to Gomez. Plays it to Andy Green. Throws it in front. It got by Yager's stick. Henrique on the follow-up. Plays it ahead. And now Gomez will shovel off the glass. Yager able to gather the loose puck. Threw it across as he beat Paul Martin to the puck. Now Larson shoots. Blocked in front. Gomez shot. Saved by Fleury. It's loose in the slot and punched away by Pittsburgh. Green is able to hold the zone. Yager on the puck. Gomez calling for it. Yager to Gomez. Shoots. And he fired it wide. Great chance for Scott Gomez to give the Devils the lead. Surge by this line now as Henrique plays it to the point. Good hold by Green. Throws it towards goal, and it's blocked away by Paul Martin. Able to pick up Evett. Two on one for the Penguins. He shoots. Save made by Schneider, who holds on.
Oh, boy. The best pressure from the Devils in some time. They get some great chances. Now the Penguins come back, but this is the shift earlier. Sidney Crosby, you can see he's been buzzing tonight. He's really looking to get himself back on the score sheet. Goes hard to the net on the wraparound, unable to bury it. There's Scotty Gomez with a glorious opportunity in the high slot. Then Andrew Evett goes the other way on a 2-on-1, elects to shoot. And Corey Schneider took a little peek, didn't know if he squeezed it enough, but in fact he did.
Here's Letang on the puck for Pittsburgh. Tries to fire through traffic, and the Devils blocked it away. An eventful opening 4.5 minutes of the third. Still scoreless. Deflected away off Tuomo Ruutu and played back to the stick of Simone Dupre. Here's Evett on the puck. 32-year-old center guides it into the zone, and Greg Adams, his senior, plays it behind the net. Evett quickly across, and he picks up Zach Sill. Tries to feed Adams. 2-2 on the loose puck, guides it back, and the return pass from Merrill is backhanded in. Marc-Andre Fleury and Corey Schneider, perfect to this point. Schneider's had the much bigger workload. He's faced 26. 9 saves for Fleury to this point. Zajac crosses up with Harrington. Seems like every time Crosby's on the ice, Zajac is on as well. His line with Havlat and Eliash tonight. Here's Kunitz, checked in the corner. Picked up here by Pittsburgh. Crosby comes away with it. Zajac draped all over him, and the puck knocked away. Guided back to the point. Portuzo with a shot. Saved by Schneider, and he holds on.
Every time Crosby on the ice is on the ice, there's some scoring chances and time spent in the Devil's zone. Corey Schneider able to cover up, make the save on Portuzo on the blast from the point. But Sidney Crosby's hungry right now. He's frustrated a little bit. He's in a mini slump. Their team hasn't scored in over 5 periods now. He's trying to will his team. But if not for the heroics of Corey Schneider, this game would be advantage Penguins, and the Devils again have to look to get some more scoring chances and some times to spend in the Penguins' end.
As they tend to Corey Schneider, this is the game recap brought to you by our good friends, the Tri-Honda dealers. Two shots on a 5-on-3 power play. Seems like a distant memory at this point in the game. That was a key sequence back in the first period. Schneider has stopped 27, and Fleury, as we mentioned, has had the easier night. Will one goal decide this?
Looks that way, and anytime that's the case, that's why you see teams fire from everywhere. It's usually a bounce, off a leg, off a skate, and go hard to the net. Make it tough on goaltenders.
Camilleri off the draw. Controlled by the Devils, and Zubris to the stick of Andy Green. Here's Adam Larson on the puck. Tries to punch it out of the zone. Kind of Zubris can't get on it. Taken instead by Robert Portuzo. Bernier put it off the linesman, and now right back to Bernier, who circles the net. Wraparound scores! Steve Bernier! And the Devils take the lead!
That's just a hard-working goal from Steve Bernier. We talk about just get pucks to the net. Well, Steve Bernier, right here, puck's turned over in neutral zone. Bortuzzo falls down. Bernier takes advantage, shields that puck real well. Doesn't stop moving his feet in the wraparound. Able to beat Marc-Andre Fleury right there as you see Harrington unable to get there, and it goes off the right skate of Marc-Andre Fleury. He does not get across in time, and the Devils take the lead.
Steve Bernier, who was outstanding on the West Coast trip. He had 3 goals in the 3 games out west. It was seemingly a simple dump in, and then Bernier inadvertently put it off the body of the linesman Ryan Galloway. That enabled him to recollect immediately, and what a finish by Bernier. Here's LaPierre weaving his way into the Devil's zone, backhanded on Schneider, who holds on. Will step aside at Prudential Center. It's the Devils leading Pittsburgh. Coming up, the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods, excitement every day.
Steve Bernier continues to be clutch the last couple of weeks. And you mentioned, made a great point, off the referee, that's part of the play. But Bortuzzo, with a combination of falling down, gives Bernier the time. Look at how he kicks the puck from his left skate up to him and doesn't miss a stride and wraps that puck around. Harrington doesn't get there quick enough, the defenseman for the Penguins. And Marc-Andre Fleury banks it off his right skate. Real good effort by Steve Bernier. A lot of things went well for him there. You mentioned the referee involved. Bortuzzo falls down. But Bernier with a real nifty skate to stick pass to himself as well.
It is an unassisted goal at 6:08. Steve Bernier's 7th of the year. Letang following up the loose puck here and sent back in deep. Sidney Crosby on the puck. We'll see a lot of him in the final 13:06. Whiffing on a chance there. Perron taken by Letang, who flutters one back in deep. Here's David Perron. Winds it around. Larson got a stick on it, but that's all. Kunitz centering try and broken up by Zajac again. Continues to be a key matchup. Zajac on Crosby here down the stretch. Picked up here by Kunitz. Crosby guides it back to the point. Taken here. Letang under some high pressure by Henrik. Off the glass behind Corey Schneider. Dupre sends it across. Spaulding is the player waiting for it. Here's Nick Spaulding on the puck. Able to pick up Crosby. Back to the point. Letang shot blocked away by Henrik. Controlled by Havlak.
That hit Adam in the left hand, and he's shaking it going to the bench.
Back come the Penguins again. Perron, blocker saved by Corey Schneider. Shoveled out of the zone by Jágr. Here's Jaromír Jágr trying to beat his man Dupre along the boards. And now punched right back in by Pittsburgh. A dozen minutes to go. Devils seeking a 3rd straight win. Penguins trying to move closer to the first place Islanders, who are idle tonight. Marek Sedlicki on the puck, banks it ahead. Offside are the Devils here. The Metropolitan Division is like this now. The Islanders lost yesterday to Boston. Penguins still within 3. To gain ground, it'll have to be come from behind tonight. Washington in the 3rd position. The Rangers occupy one of the 2 Eastern Conference wildcard berths at this time, but a lot of season left.
Yeah, you see, it's going to get more bunched up. Seems like the Flyers, Devils as well, trying to creep into it a little bit. That's why every game is so crucial, and Devils lead the Penguins 1-0 with 11:32 left in the game.
Bortuzzo back here for Pittsburgh. It's a nice in call again. Wasn't sure they would get the call there, but it'll come back. And the faceoff back in the Devils' end.
Well, you think he's lost even more hair through this time going back in the bench, but all kidding aside, general manager and now goal coach Lou Lamoriello, I mean, such a positive guy in the bench. He really is. He lets the 2 guys, Adam Oates and Scott Stevens, coach. And he's more of a positive impact for the players that are coming off the ice.
Puck loose behind the Devils' net. LaPierre sees it taken away by Harold. Lou said after the game 2 nights ago, that's one we wouldn't have won earlier in the season. see if there's a similar comment to follow if the Devils hold this lead. Still better than 11 minutes to go. Zubras tries to punch it out of the zone. Hammered right back by Harrington. Collected by Peter Harrell for the Devils. Sent the length of the ice again. Icing again against New Jersey.
There you look at Marty Hablett. 4 points last four games. And the Devils didn't have much going last game in Toronto. Similar tonight as far as offensive chance. When I thought, again, Marty Hablett created, it was a big part of the tying goal, his line, spending time in the Toronto end when Larson tied it up.
They load the gun, shot from the point by Dupre, went wide, trying to track it down as Kunitz, and he is hammered to the ice by Zadina Zubras. Loose puck, Camilleri. Bumps with Letang, and it's taken here by Pittsburgh. 1-0 Devils worked across to the stick of Perron for Crosby, who shoots, big save made by Schneider. The one-timer by Crosby didn't go. Corey Schneider's 30th save of the night. What a beauty. At the side of the net, Crosby again. Kunitz following up. Puck collected by Green. And he'll lift it away. My goodness.
Well, you just have to think he has Sidney Crosby shaking his head. You mentioned 30 saves. That was the best of the night. On the best player in the world, Sidney Crosby.
Centering try to the stick of Eliash, who'll punch it away. And Havlat will give chase. This is a sellout crowd tonight at Prudential Center that's enjoying this Devils lead midway through the third. Followed up here, Spalling, shoot, save made by Schneider again. Popped up high and gloved down by Zydlitzki. Devils try to punch it out of the zone, and they do. Quickly gaining the zone again, Pittsburgh. Hornquist works it across, looking for the cutting Spalling. Now Sutter behind the net. Centering try, knocked off the stick of Hornquist. Taken here by Martin. Back to Brandon Sutter. Shot by Martin. Through traffic is off a leg in front. Sutter again. Guides it back to the point. Bouncing puck controlled by Martin and funneled into the corner. Adam Henrique trying to work it out of the zone. Scuderi. Under pressure, works it across to the stick of Andrew Evett. Here's Evett shooting, saved by Schneider with Hornquist at the doorstep. Corey Schneider stops play. 9:04 to go.
Corey Schneider's going to rob Sidney Crosby in front. The pass from Perron. Crosby goes hard to the net, and Corey Schneider, we take a look at it from a good angle right here, gets the right pad on it. Looks like it's going to go through the legs, and the left pad sweeps across and knocks it out. Look at the speed determination from Crosby going hard to the net. Nice feed from Perron, but denied by Corey Schneider again.
Camilleri to take the draw. Maxime LaPierre in the circle with him. The Devils have 10 shots and the lead. Off the draw, Bortuzzo punches into the corner. Here's Steve Downey on the puck for Pittsburgh. NHL leader in penalty minutes is Downey. Back to the point, shot by Bortuzzo, stopped by Schneider at the side of the net. Pittsburgh quickly on the loose puck again as Downey works it back. Harrington fires it wide of the net, and Zubras with one hand on the stick gets it out of the zone. Back come Pittsburgh again as Downey fires in. Here's Merrill punching it ahead. Scuderi holding the zone for the Penguins. Merrill plays it ahead. Perron on the intercept for Pittsburgh. Punched away by Harold and put back to center.
Penguin defenseman putting on a full court pressure in the Devil's zone. They are coming all the way down to the hash marks, just pressing, trying to get anything going and get that equalizer. But boy, are the Penguins on the puck quick. All over the ice.
Here's Andy Green firing into the Penguins' end. Shoveled away by Fleury and taken here by Rob Scuderi. Given away, taken here by Havlat. Backhand try, and he put the puck over the crossbar.
Scuderi not happy.
Back to the point. Larson's got it. Redirected, and that shot sticked aside by Marc-Andre Fleury and taken by Pittsburgh.
Sam Scuderi not happy, as you thought. Travis Sajak should have had a penalty before the great chance from Marty Hablett.
Kunitz lost his edge at center ice, taken by Andy Green. 7.5 to go. Here's Jágr at center ice. Tries to dump in. Met by Brandon Sutter. Taken by the Penguins. And here comes Sutter racing into the Devil's zone. Ex-Carolina Hurricane sealed off here by Zidlitsky. Sutter trying to stay strong on the puck. Centering try. Gets back to the point. Shot by Letang. That shot did not go. Did it go off the pipe?
He ripped that, and I think it did hit the post directly. We'll take a look at it on the replay. That was a rocket from Letang, and Penguins just can't find the back of the net yet.
Taken by Spaulding, back to Dupre. Jágr got a stick on that to break it up. Downey plays it behind the net. Good pressure by this unit for the Penguins. Here's Steve Downey on the puck. Gives it back. Centering try by Sutter. Spaulding hit by Jágr from behind. He was tied up nicely. The Penguins stay with it. Dupre shoots. That got through to Schneider. He made the save. Behind the net.
This is just unbelievable.
Downey throws it in front. Collected by LaPierre. That shot redirected. Oh, Letang with a shot. And Schneider with the denial again. More pressure by Pittsburgh. Letang back to the point. LaPierre's got it. His shot stopped by Gomez. The Devils need a clear badly and a change. Loose in front. Taken by Jágr. Tripped up on the play. No penalty called. And Schneider makes another save on Letang.
Remarkable. This is an absolute shooting gallery for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Gomez one-on-one. And Fleury makes a save. 5:50 to go. That's the man of the hour.
Penguins' Chris Letang finally gets one past Corey Schneider, but it dings off the far post. What a shot and blast by Chris Letang. They can't buy one. Then LaPierre shoots a puck, deflects right to Letang, and just a remarkable save again from Corey Schneider getting across there. Letang net shift for about a minute. Hit the post from the right side, had a great chance from the dot. Hashmark on the left side. He was playing rover all over the place, trying anything to get the puck past Corey Schneider. And nothing happening there, nothing doing for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Off the draw, it's taken by Adams, who works it in. Pittsburgh giving the fourth liners a crack here, trailing by a goal with 5:37 to go. In truth, all of their lines have been effective tonight and created chances. Loose behind the net. Harrell funnels it ahead, taken by Camilleri, who tries to work it out of the zone and does. Letang is all over the ice. It is amazing to see him positioned where you might not expect to see the defenseman. Let's go downstairs. Deb Placey. Deb?
We have covered back-to-back wins on the Jag physical therapy postgame. No matter how this one ends, we will be there with the Jag postgame. I guarantee you'll see a couple more of those Corey Schneider saves again and the goal. In the locker room, all the interviews, the Lou Lamoriello press conference, John McClain, Ken Danico, everybody coming up on the Jag physical therapy postgame.
Sounds like a busy show. I'll keep my part brief, I promise. Off the draw, it's taken by Pittsburgh and collected by Adam Larson. See a lot of him and Andy Green down the stretch, surely. Gomez will wind it around. Letang stepping right back on for Pittsburgh, has the puck and works it ahead. Jágr takes it. Gomez with a shot right at Marc-Andre Fleury, who made the save.
And here comes Travis Sajak. You mentioned the job he's done helping out Larson and Green facing Corey Schneider's line. He's done a good job. You know, he's so sound defensively.
You're watching the Foxwoods Final Five. Foxwoods excitement every day. Visit foxwoods.com. Hasn't that man had an exciting night? 36 saves.
You'd have to think he's a little tired, but goaltenders will tell you every once in a while we like some action. Keeps us in the game. Well, he's had plenty of that tonight against the Penguins, and somehow, some way, the Devils have to kill 4:48 of time here and win this hockey game, an improbable win if it happens.
Larson off the draw, has a shot blocked away. The Devils have another game tomorrow night, and the Devils are telling us that's already a sellout against the Florida Panthers coming in. Picked up by Kunitz, and got it over the line. Here's Green, hammered against the boards. This is the Penguins' top line on. Crosby, Perron, and Kunitz. Work to the stick of Adam Larson, who punches it ahead. Batted away by Patrick Elias, and now Havlat trying to pick up the loose puck. 4:12 to go in regulation time in a 1-0 game. Letang to the stick of Simone Dupre. Works it ahead. Offside is Pittsburgh here. Lexus brings us a look at the upcoming schedule. I said it's a sellout tomorrow night. That'll be game 3 of the 5-game homestand against the Panthers. The rest of the homestand, Ottawa Tuesday. The Maple Leafs again on Friday. All of those games on MSG+. Deb Lacy, Johnny Mack with the great Visa Devils game night half an hour prior to each.
Just great to see the fans, the support. And we've seen packed houses a lot of the time this season, Steve, here in Prudential Center under some tough times. But the Devils looking for another victory here, up 1-0 late against the Penguins.
Corey Schneider doesn't like what he sees. Arcabello in his face. He'll stop play again. What do you talk about in these situations? 1-0, you know one mistake can ruin the night. What are you discussing?
Well, you know you've been outplayed, obviously, and you got to be very pleased that you're up 1-0. Give your goaltender some help here. Make sure you get the puck out. There's no time to get fancy now. They've been on their heels. Only 3:47 left. Puck's off the glass and out.
Spalling plays this. That shot blocked away by John Merrill, and it caroms out of the zone. Henrique trying to get on the loose puck. Ties up Spalling and taken away by Pittsburgh. Letang. Checked by Jágr, and a stoppage in play here. What do we have?
It's just a high stick of the puck, and faceoff will go all the way back to the Devils in or no, a neutral zone at the dot.
They're going to give Peter Harrell a penalty here, Dano.
Hey, I was confused there for a second because it looked like he was just calling a high stick, and the faceoff was going outside. Right there, you see Peter Harrell clip, but this is from way back in the Devil's zone. And the puck ended up going all the way in the Penguin zone. Devils never touched it. So it was a little confusing. This is a big kill for the Devils with 3:29 left.
Penguins power play 0-for-2. They control off the faceoff. Letang able to hold it at the blue line. Fakes the shot. That try by Perron is blocked away by Schneider. Perron guides it back to the point. Here's Letang to Crosby. His shot saved by Schneider. They score on the rebound. The Penguins, with 3:11 to go, finally break the ice and tie the game on their 38th shot of the night.
Oh, boy. Corey Schneider made two saves before this, and finally, the Pittsburgh Penguins on the power play. In front, able to tie this hockey game on the rebound. We look again, the blast right here on the setup from Letang to Crosby, and looks like Chris Kunitz is going to get this goal. Crosby on the one-timer, big save, but it caroms out to Kunitz, shall I say, and he batted that bouncing puck out of midair and put it upstairs over Corey Schneider, and that's really too bad. Corey Schneider had been absolutely remarkable up till then, and this is a tie hockey game.
Here's Fleury in his own end. Kept in by Merrill. Bouncing puck. Zubris guides it back to the point again, and Merrill sends it in deep. Bernier and Kunitz exchanging third period goals. The game is tonight where we were Wednesday at this point. 1-1, roughly 2.5 minutes to go. The Penguins have iced the puck here.
There's Corey Schneider. I mean, it looked like it was one of those nights where nothing was going to get by him, but the Devils take the late penalty. Pittsburgh had been spending so much time in the Devils' zone, they finally get a loose man in front on the rebound and tie this game up.
Gomez to take the draw against LaPierre. Here's Jágr. Hit by LaPierre, but the Devils stay strong on the puck. Henrique to Zydlitzky. He shoots, fought off, juggled by Fleury, who holds on. There was Jágr lurking in the danger area.
Good shot by Zydlitzky. Good work in the corner. Adam Henrique spinning off some Penguins and getting it back. Zydlitzky, nobody was able to get in front and screen Fleury. He's able to make the save. Puck up high. Agar goes for a swipe at it, but Fleury covers up. Gets it in his glove.
Here's Gomez to take the draw against Sutter. Off the draw, Henrique controls for the Devils. Throws it in front. Jágr gets a shot away. Saved by Fleury. Devils trying to dig for the loose puck, but Marc-Andre Fleury, suddenly busy, has got it.
Real good work from the Jágr. Henrique Gomez line getting some chances here. Real good anticipation. Adam Henrique jumping in after the faceoff and beating Penguins the puck, getting it to the front of the net. And Jaromir Jágr there, spins around. Fleury able to find the bouncing puck, but good chance from the Devils. And good response after the Penguins tied it. We know the Penguins have had the majority of play in the Devils' zone, but the Devils, good bounce back shift, good chances there.
Zajac fires in. Puck gets by Fleury. Here's Eliash for New Jersey. Gives to Martin Havlat. He'll wind around. Here's Adam Larson. Sends it in deep. Havlat, centering try, put it off the back of the net, and Crosby gathers this for the Penguins. Lifts it ahead. He was looking for Kunitz on the bomb. Icing is waved off. Kunitz was the first man in. Tries to pick up Crosby, the trailer, who fanned on the shot. Here's Havlat, works it across. Travis Zajac back for the Devils. Broken up by Scuderi. Crashing into the goal was Eliash, who slowly back to his skates, but now fully back up. On the tying goal by Kunitz, we see Green with a shot redirected by Eliash, and it went wide. Give the assist to Crosby and Letang. The power play goal to tie it at 16:49. Here's Sutter over the line. Brandon Sutter, nice maneuver, and he controls behind the net. Drops it back for Paul Martin. His try blocked away by the skater Fraser. Zubris is tied up by Martin, ex-teammates in New Jersey. Just over a minute to play. Hornquist now trying to find the handle on the loose puck as it's sent all the way back. And as Letang goes back, it's icing with 56 seconds to go in the third.
Pittsburgh Penguins, you mentioned the four lines, most of them getting chances, but they've been led and finally got the equalizer from their big guns. Crosby with the shot, Letang with a nice pass. He's been all over the ice, and you can see why right now. He's one of the elite defensemen in the game and is on a roll as he picks up an assist on the tying goal in Chris Kunitz, where he makes a living in front of that net.
Here's Camilleri to take the draw against LaPierre. Face-off win by Camilleri. Devils can't get it out of the zone, though. Loose puck taken here by Spaulding. Gets a backhand try away. That's blocked away. And the puck taken here by Bernier. Zubris was at the tail end of his shift and had to get to the bench. Puck taken here by Letang, who lifts it away for Pittsburgh. Green controls at center. Tries to send Henrique on his way. The Penguins met them effectively. Half a minute to go in the third. Here's Downey trying to split some red jerseys. Taken away by Green and punched out the center. Simon Dupre on the puck for Pittsburgh. We're 18 seconds from overtime. LaPierre drops it back. Now Dupre on the puck for the Penguins, who lifts in. Larson winds it around for Green. Looks up at the scoreboard. 6 seconds to go. Icing is waved off. We're heading for overtime at Prudential Center. The Devils and Penguins are tied at one. A 40-save night already. He might need to make more. Yeah. Welcome back to the New York Life Overtime Report. New York Life, keep good going. There are regulars here at Prudential Center who have this sense of deja vu, optimistically. Didn't we do this two nights ago?
You didn't think you got your money's worth yet? Well, we're going to an extra session, possibly a shootout. Again, we're here because of the display of goaltending from Corey Schneider for the New Jersey Devils, as the Penguins fired 20 shots on him that period and finally scored late with just over 3 minutes left on the power play to tie the hockey game. But man, oh man, has he played some good hockey lately. And the Devils try to find a way to win in overtime. We're going to see some action here with the ice opening up.
So much of the news and talk of the last 48 hours concerning a former Devils goaltender and future Hall of Famer, Corey Schneider, split time with Marty Brodeur last season, he was very careful to point out yesterday that Brodeur was gracious in handing the net to me. Those were his words, and that's not lost on me moving forward. Those are very big shoes to fill. Not everyone equipped to handle that. As he plays more and more games, the workload, and we've seen it in particular in this stretch just wrapped around the All-Star break, he's delivered something special. Tonight might have been the best of the bunch.
Yeah, this really was. I mean, he's the reason the Devils have gotten a point already, and that is a lot of pressure. You're replacing arguably the best goaltender who ever played the game. You can't tell me you feel that, but Corey Schneider has handled it relatively well. In fact, spectacular, especially the last two, 3 weeks.
Crosby and Kunitz start the overtime for Pittsburgh with Letang on the puck here. Thanks it ahead. Kunitz with a shot held by Schneider and no rebound there.
Chris Letang, I expect nothing different. He's going to be jumping up into the play and all over the ice four and four. So if there's somebody on the Devils forwards doesn't have their head on a swivel and looks around to pick him up, it's going to be trouble. He's a guy that's so dangerous, especially in this situation, 4-on-4.
Zajac and Henrique, the forward tandem. Devils have numbers here. It's a 4-on-2 with two Penguins trapped. That pass across off the stick, though, of Adam Henrique. Taken by Letang and worked ahead to Sidney Crosby. Here comes the Penguins' captain. Tries to make his move on Larson, who got a stick on it to break it up. Puck taken away here by Green. Green tries to work it ahead, deflected away off Perron, who's come on. Devils make the change. John Merrill steps on. Eliash and Hatlott, the forward tandem, but here comes Letang. Tries to pick up Perron. Tries to dance into the Devils' end, now banks it back to Chris Letang. Has a lane, shoots and fires it wide. Arcabello off the bench for the Penguins, plays it back in deep. Centering try, deflected away. This will come back to Paul Martin. He's under pressure from Hatlott and got rid of it in time. Larson to Merrill. And Eliash now settles this down for New Jersey. John Merrill picks up Hatlott. That pass too far for Eliash. Sent back into the Penguins' end, and Scuderi banks it across. Mark Arcabello. Claimed on waivers from Nashville. Playing here in overtime with Hornquist. Sent in deep to the zone. Centering try by the Penguins. Yager steps on now. He and Gomez the forward tandem. And Scott Gomez will take this for New Jersey. Stripped of the puck by Sutter. Tried to work it across for the cutting Kunitz, but that's broken up.
A real nice play by John Merrill.
Kunitz again on the puck. They drop it back to the point. Here's Letang. Chris passing by the Penguins and played across. Back to Chris Letang with Gomez there on him. Tried to funnel it in deep. Kicked that by DeBray. Plays it across. Quick shot. Big save by Schneider as he denied Brandon Sutter. Corey Schneider on the one-time shot by Sutter. One of his best of the night. Letang again to Sutter. Back to the point. DeBray scores! Simone DeBray! It got by Schneider and the Penguins win it in overtime.
Well, Corey Schneider again was just under siege 4-on-4 here. He makes a sparkling save on Brandon Sutter a few seconds earlier, but the Penguins able to keep the puck in the zone. And Simone Dupree just fires a quick wrist shot with people in front. The Penguins win it overtime. Corey Schneider was spectacular. The goal of the game is brought to you by Nissan. Choose Nissan today for great offers on our most exciting lineup ever. Shop at ChooseNissan.com. And the goal of the game is going to come. There's the save on Brandon Sutter. Shortly after, right here, puck gets back from Brandon Sutter to Simone Dupree. First Letang. Look at the puck movement by them. To Sutter back in the middle, and he takes the quick wrist shot. I'm not sure if Kunitz got any piece of that in front. We'll look again. Now it looks like it went directly in, but it was through a maze of players. And smart Simone Dupree just gets that puck on net. That's your Nissan goal of the game. The game winner in overtime. And the Pittsburgh Penguins stuck with it and earned themselves a hard-fought victory.
For Simone Dupree, just his second goal of the season. The Devils take three of a possible 4 points to start the homestand. The Panthers are here tomorrow night. The postgame presented by JAG Physical Therapy. Straight ahead as the Penguins win in overtime.